Have you been struggling to get exercise over the past year? Have you just been hunched over at your computer with bad posture, not flailing your arms and legs enough to get that blood pumping? Do you really feel like your sit down at the computer gaming experience needs to be exercisified? Well, look no further than my bad idea. So basically, you know a game controller. What I want to do is take each of the thumbsticks, instead of a thumbstick, use an accelerometer, and stick it on my wrist, and then you control the game like this. And you're getting exercise, you're moving around, it's like the Wii. I'm basically reinventing the wheel. I think we are gonna have a really good time, and let's get started. So first things first, I printed these frames. They look a little bit like a shaver on the end there. I printed them purple to match the game controller itself. You can check out that video if you want. Inside each of these little arm nuggins is gonna have an Arduino with an advanced processor that can emulate a mouse or whatever. One of them is gonna have an Arduino Leonardo, and the other one is gonna have the internals from the gesture mouse. It is an Arduino Yun. You can check out that video if you feel like it. It'll be linked above, but essentially the same thing. The Yun is a bit overkill for this, but it doesn't really matter. They will also both have an accelerometer in them, which will obviously measure the movement of you when you're doing this, and they will each have a button that comes out the front so that you can click. So I'll just put it there in the case, slap a breadboard on top for the accelerometer on there, glue it all up shut, and Bob's your uncle. Then the only thing left to do is to attach the straps. And here we have it. Straps are attached. I didn't film me doing that. They're done. This one is for the left-hand side. It controls WASD. This one is for the right-hand side. It controls your mouse. I really think this is going to be the next innovation in game design. You know, the Wii was really great and all. It was innovative and all that stuff, but it lacked the adaptability to work with every game. So, like, I've never seen anyone play GTA on a Wii or Cyberpunk on a Wii, mostly because the Wii was launched a good time before those games, but also because its control scheme was not standardized. And this is gonna be standard. It's gonna give standard PC inputs, like keyboards and mouses and stuffs. And it's gonna work somewhat well, hopefully. Let's give it a test. Hello, this is Noah from about 30 hours later. I thought I was gonna film it right after the last piece, but I didn't. I fired up Cyberpunk, and let's give the gesture controller a test. So I'm just gonna put these on my wrist here. Starting to feel like a character from Cyberpunk now with all my cyberware on and stuff. That's high tech, this. It should home where my arm is facing when I plug it in. Each of these is one stick, so to look around, I can look like that. Without the other direction, up and down, and to move, I can move forward, backwards, left and right with this stick. It does seem to like to lock on forward. I don't really know why that is. I can also aim and fire my gun. Overall, I'm starting to get the idea that this is a absolutely horrible concept. I have no control of myself because it's a very unintuitive control scheme and keeps locking, going up. This is a horrible idea. This is just awful. I thought this would like work a little bit, but I can't. Oh, if I go behind me, I can look down. There we go. All right. Why it's like this? I wish I knew. Also, why am I looking to the side? Oh, that's gonna have to get blurred out.
Why is that?
I'm not going back to show you. Well, not on purpose, at least. Oh, damn it. Should I get in the car? Let's drive. Oh my god. I'm doing nothing right now. I'm doing absolutely nothing. This is unplayable.
Okay, so now Lisa is giving it a go.
Try not to crash Johnny's car into the seat. So how do you feel?
Dizzy!
So that didn't exactly go to plan. These things? Useless. They are awful. I thought they would have like a little bit of merit to them, but they just were not good at all in any way, shape, or form. I would normally say, you know, back to the drawing board, let's make this work, but I think there were some flaws with this that are just inherent to the concept itself. It would seem that it's the entire idea that is flawed. Some sort of highlight issues, other than the general unintuitive controls, are these accelerometer modules, very cheap, very affordable, but also not very reliable. And they were constantly shifting the dead zone all over the place, drifting here and there. If you whipped your hand across the screen, your dead zone was all of a sudden over here. So when using it, I had no idea where to put my hand to get the character to just stop. Long story short, they're just kind of bad. And that's okay. Not every idea is a good one, and sometimes things end up being duds like this. If you like this video, maybe consider subscribing or checking out one of my other videos. There was one where I built a game controller that actually worked and was kind of better than these. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day. Ooh, that didn't sound good.